Okay. We're gonna pick up where we left off. We got through Ezekiel 31, but as promised, we need to go back and break it down, because we merely read it last time, and we want to get into what these words actually mean. So you'll have a fuller understanding of this no trees idea. In Ezekiel 31:3, we'll start there. Behold, the Assyrian was a cedar in Lebanon, with fair branches and with a shattering shroud and in high stature, and his top was among the thick boughs. This word Assyrian is actually Asher, and it is more than the Assyrian type and the historical figure of the Assyrian. Is actually a type and pattern of Satan himself, and many of the subjects throughout the scripture are related to the branch, the righteous branch, which is Yeshua Messiah, and the worship of Asherah, the, as we read here, not a good thing, Asherah. And we'll get into some study of the word Asherah. It's from the Greek, from the Hebrew, actually, root Asherah, to be straight, erect, or upright. From this comes the meaning, in a moral sense, to be upright, hence to prosper or be happy in the best sense. We'll find that's the best possible rendering. The Asherah was so called because it was something set upright or erect in the ground and worshipped. The word occurs 40 times in scripture, and we'll look at each one of these. It will take us a while to get through this, and only a careful study of each passage will give a correct view so that you can see for yourself. Compared with this, all that men think or say about Asher is of little value. The word is always rendered in the English grove or groves, and in the translation here, always the proper name in the Revised Version of the King James. In the Revised Version, it is left as Asher instead of groves or trees. We learn that it was either a living tree with the top cut off and the stump or trunk fashioned into a certain shape. Deuteronomy 16:21 is a good place to look for, to read more about that shape. Or it was artificially fashioned, set erect in the ground, as in Isaiah 8:1, Kings 14:13, and First Kings 16:33. It was made of wood, as we see in Judges 6:26, or stone. It's indicated, the shape of it is indicated in 1 Kings 15:13 and 2 Chronicles 15:16 chapters, where it is an idol in a grove, should be as in an abominable image for an Asherah. It could be cut down, as in Exodus 34:13, which is the first occurrence of the word. We will go and look at this. First occurrences are interesting study, because they are usually set the stage for understanding of the Hebrew word in general. But here we are in Ezekiel 34:13. But ye shall destroy their altars, break their images, and cut down their groves. This was Yahweh speaking emphatically to his people. Their groves is this Hebrew word Asherah, which is actually what we're speaking of in Ezekiel 31 when we say Assyrian. It's really Asherah, a phallic image worshipped in libidinous rites and lascivious practices. That's the first occurrence of the word. It is plucked up, as in Micah 5:14, burnt, as in Deuteronomy 12:3, or broken in pieces, 2 Chronicles 34:4, is often coupled with Maserat, of stone pillars in the Revised Version, and rendered images in the AV, is connected with Baal worship. That it could not have been a grove in the classic sense is what we know, is that in 2 Kings 17:10, it is forbidden to set one up under any green tree. So it could also be very distinct from a tree. So we get here the word twice in one sentence. We get the word tree and we get the word Asherah. So Asherah is specifically an image of abomination, which is the main image of Satan worship. While it is distinguished from Ashtoreth, the goddess, it is yet associated with that goddess, Ashtoreth being representative of the productive or passive principle of life, and Baal being representative of the generative or active principle, the male principle. The image which represents the Phoenician Ashtoreth of Paphos as the sole object of worship.